Cannonball!
That was idiotic. What compelled you to do such a thing?
Well, it's basically summertime, right? So I decided that I wanted to kind of get in the mood, and it didn't really go to plan.
Oh, really? And welcome to this episode of the show. Given it's our last one as seniors, I've decided to take it nice and slow.
All right, just promise to me that you won't do one of those cringy last goodbye videos, because those are about my breaking point. I've got some severe senioritis.
You've heard somewhere that there's actually no such thing as lactose intolerance because the average person actually can't drink milk, right?
Yeah, I think I recall hearing that biology, yeah.
Well, maybe. It's the ones without senioritis that are actually the weirdos, similar to the people who are actually lactose persistent.
What's up, guys? I'm Kylie.
And I'm Cole. And today we are doing tech talks, but during truck day. Who are you?
Cadence Randall.
Is this your truck behind us?
Yes, it is.
What's your favorite part of your truck?
The cowl hood.
How many cases of 24-pack Mountain Dew can you haul in this thing?
100? I don't know.
Rookie maybe numbers.
I think we should try that out. Oh, yeah, what's your truck?
It is a 1995 Chevy 2500.
How much was your truck?
Well, due to the no-fault insurance claim.
Tell me about your previous trucks.
Oh, geez, I've only had one actual previous truck. That was my 96 Chevy 1500.
What happened there?
Got rear-ended by a semi.
Anyways, back to the comment about this truck. How much did it cost?
Well, $3,000 was the insurance no-fault claim.
Woot woot.
So I only paid $3,000 for the truck.
So what a steal. Woot.
Six.
All right, is there anything else you'd like to say about your truck?
No.
All right, so who are you?
My name's Cameron Brown. I attend North Huron.
Yeah, tell us about your truck.
So this is a 94 F-350.
Sweet.
A 460 Big Block. Me and my dad, we bought this thing probably 6 years ago now. Paid $500 for it. It was rotten. Tore it right down to the bare frame and completely rebuilt it from the ground up.
What was it like rebuilding it?
It was fun. A lot of father-son bonding. I enjoy doing this stuff. I grew up working on trucks with my dad. We've been doing a lot of this. We're actually restoring another one of these trucks right now. That's a four-door long bed.
And so how do you feel about truck day?
Oh, it's fun. A little change pace gets us out of the shop.
Nice.
So yeah, what's your favorite truck memory?
My favorite truck memory? Probably the day we bought this thing, because when we bought it, the rear leaf spring perches were snapped and the leaf springs were pushing up through the bed. My dad was riding on this thing going home. I thought we were going to lose the rear axle.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Pretty cool. How much do tires run you on here?
I don't know. We usually buy used tires. We don't drive it. This thing gets crappy fuel mileage. We don't drive it enough to burn tires off of it. But it will.
What's the mileage like?
On a good day, 8.
Oh, my.
I had a Ford Focus. I got 40 miles to the gallon. I sold it and bought a truck that gets 10.
I don't like driving trucks.
Financial decisions.
Yeah.
Good choices.
Oh, yeah.
My mom totaled her Ford Focus. She hit a deer with it and it just went.
That's the only thing about these old trucks. My 87, I hit a deer with one at 55. Didn't even scratch it.
Who are you?
Ryan Eisler.
Is this your truck behind us?
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about your truck?
It's a Kenworth W900 with a Caterpillar engine in it.
What is this truck used to hauling?
Hauls a lot of feed for cattle and all that, and some for farmers and all that, and gravel.
Have you, like, drove this truck?
Yeah, I drove it here, and I drive it all the time.
All right, when did you start driving it?
About 2 years ago.
Do you like driving semis?
Yeah.
Who are you?
My name is Kyle Holdwick.
Who are you, actually?
Kyle Holdwick. From Holdwick Acres.
All right. Can you tell me about this truck?
This is a 1984 Kenworth W990.
Is there anything special about it?
It has a sleeper on it.
What is that exactly?
That's where people sleep at the end of the day.
Yeah, that makes sense. Do you have any specific memories with this truck?
Yeah. So when my parents bought it, they just kind of parked it inside and never used it because it was too nice. And now we actually get to use it now.
Huh. So does this truck have any, like, actually special features about it?
Not really. It's just a normal 1984 Kenworth
W990. I hear some talking going on up there.
Yeah, they're on the CBs going back and forth.
Just. What are we talking about up here?
Interview, Kyle.
Me and Caleb are talking about our trucks back and forth.
Oh, yeah, that's why that's... That was amazing. All right, is there anything else you'd like to add?
Nope, that's about it.
All right, thank you so much.
Yep.
You know, Kid Rock used to participate in Truck Day back before the fast food drive-thru incident back in the summer of 2020.
I'm afraid to ask, but my curiosity outweighs my apprehension.
Well, let's just say there was a forced adoption of a baby alligator by a customer service worker. His license was taken, but not his spirit. Seems that's the way it goes down in the swamps.
So it seems. Anyways, here's Dylan with his summer hits, and after that, a word from our sponsor.
Hello, I'm Dylan, and I will be reviewing summer music. There are 5 songs that I have listened to and decided to review. The first song I will be reviewing is Summertime by DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. Weird name for an artist. Summertime is a song that I enjoy listening to when I want to listen to a song that is calm. It is a very popular song that may have popularized the term, if it ain't broke, don't try to fix it. Personally, I think it's an 8 out of 10. A second song was suggested by a fellow member of this episode who I will not name, and the song is called All Summer Long by Kid Rock. Personally, this song is new to me, but I'm still gonna review it anyways. You know, the song is a good song with a good beat, and I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. Alright, so the third song I'm going to be reviewing is Walking on Sunshine by Katrina and the Waves. This is another popular song. It's a good song with a good beat, and I personally enjoy it, and it's most certainly memorable. There's really not much else I can say about it. I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. Alright, so the fourth song I'll be reviewing is Sweet Home Alabama by Lynyrd Skynyrd. And yeah, this is a song y'all should know, and this song was the artist was suggested by the same person who suggested Kid Rock. I'm not gonna name him still. It's a very good song that's... was probably meant to tell you that Alabama isn't as bad as the other song from the time would want you to believe. Personally, I think it's a great song to listen to. I'm gonna give that song a 9 out of 10. Alright, so the fifth and final song is School's Out by Alice Cooper. It's a song about school being out, and I enjoy listening to it. It's a song that kids would probably enjoy listening to once school is out for the year. So yeah, I'm enjoying the song and I'm gonna give it a 10 out of 10. Now that I gave my scores, I would like to know what you guys think. Oh wait, I don't think I can figure that out. Anyways, back to the show. Wait, why does it say an ad will play soon?
Lemonade! Woo! We have a customer. Hi!
It's 1/4.
1/4. 52 cents.
Yeah. 52 cents or 1/4. It's 1/4. Or 52 cents.
Or 52 cents.
No, 1/4 is 52 cents.
God, this is.
Yeah, that seems like a little too much. Still too much.
Yeah.
Oh, hopefully, I want to drink this is my water. That's a little thirsty. Yeah. Would you like some ice? It's kind of warm.
It's warm?
Yeah.
No.
It's a little bit warm.
No.
We've been out here for a while, so.
It's cold out.
No.
Summer.
Yeah, we've been out here for a while.
Summer.
It's summer, man. It's like
sun.
58 degrees in winter.
Can you see the sun?
I'll have some ice.
All right, so.
Can you see the sun?
No.
Well, you're blind. My dogs!
What is in this?
Is it good?
What is in this?
It's lemonade.
Lemonade!
Thank you. Hey, whoa, wait. No. Wait. Ah, Dakota.
No!
Come back!
Lemonade!
I got the money.
We're in Texas.
Don't ask where she went.
Did you kill her?
That's a story for another day. Alright, I'm gonna go see if I can scout out some customers, alright?
For one quarter, lemonade. The best lemonade in the South Mid.
Lemonade and crap.
Best No!
I'm telling my dad!
Give me my lemonade!
You know.
I paid up!
Have you ever heard the saying, pay it forward? I think that's what the last guy did. Oh.
I don't think you're right. This is the most mid lemonade in the South Mid.
Oh. Yeah.
Delectable.
Dude, I think we're gonna get shut down.
We poisoned someone.
Oh.
So, we're going to play a little game that I like to call Florida Roulette. In front of me are two drinks. One is lemonade, the other is filled with all sorts of nasty things. It's better that I don't mention exactly what went into the second cup. Basically, there's a 50-50 chance you either drink normal lemonade or some devious liquids.
Okay, I'll play ball.
Alright, sounds great, but first, what's that?
Huh? Where?
Must have been a bird.
Oh, wait. We're inside.
Big mosquito, then?
All right. But I suppose we should drink up, then.
Oh, no.
Would you like to do the honors?
We drink at the same time. Clearly.
All right. Well, cheers.
Thumbs up.
You guessed wrong.
Aha! You only thought I guessed wrong. I switched out the glasses when you weren't looking. You fell victim to one of my classic blunders.
All right. Let's cut to the next segment while I do this. All right, sir. I have you roll over for me.
E-M-E-L-I-G-H-I-E.
Are we talking to Dixie May?
Yes, this is she.
Okay. What's your favorite summer meal?
I love popcorn with cottage cheese. Girl dinner, you know? I like a basket of fried chicken and some venison we got for free on the side of the road.
What's your favorite summer staple jewelry?
I love anything by Kendra Scott. My wedding ring, which I do not have on right now because I had to sell it to a pawn shop to afford my husband's crippling Bass Pro Shop addiction.
How do you usually put your hair up?
I love putting my hair in a claw clip because, you know, especially when I get into a car accident, it'll give permanent damage to my skull, and I just love that for me.
Why should I put my hair up? I'm not trying to look good for no one.
What's your favorite water bottle for the summer?
My Stanley, of course.
My camo cozy.
Do you have a special somebody to go to the beach with?
So, I'm just a girl, so no. However, me and my for-lifer love going to 7-Eleven late at night to get slushies.
Yes, my husband Bill, though he annoys me half to death because every other week I gotta buy him new Gucci's because he keeps putting skid marks in them and I can't wash them out.
That's all I have for our questions for today, but thank you for answering them and being here.
Of course, girly. I love talking about myself. It's just like so refreshing, you know?
Bless your heart.
Bill! Where are you, you good for nothing fat lord?
All right, we need another segment, guys.
And I'm with
Brooklyn Hayes.
What are your plans after school, Brooke?
College.
Do you want to leave any advice for newcomers here?
Don't let anyone tell you that you can't enjoy your hobbies. And good luck.
What's your name?
Dylan King.
What are your plans after school?
I'm probably gonna enter the workforce, like for either photography or videography, and if that doesn't work, I might go into music.
Any reason why?
I feel like those are like the three things I'm really interested in.
Okay, do you have any advice for those who's going to be coming next year?
I would say, like, you should, like, not take it too unseriously. Like, there are some things that you should take seriously about the class, but you should have fun as well. But don't take it too much like a joke.
Hello, what's your name?
Wesley Fritz.
And what are your plans after school?
Michigan State University.
Why did you choose that?
My mother went there, and I would also like to go there, so I went there.
So family tradition?
Ish.
Do you have any advice for anybody who's going to be joining next year?
Here's come.
Anywhere.
Trust your teachers. As annoying as they can be, they do tend to know the best. I hate to admit it.
Are you going to miss this place?
Probably. Odds are Turner will let me just drop in.
Well, thank you. Have a great day. Hello?
Hey.
What's your name?
Cole Adams.
And what are your plans after school?
I'm going to move away out west somewhere. I'm thinking either Wyoming or Texas.
Why?
Because I just don't like it here that much.
Do you have any advice for any of those who's coming next year?
Get out of here.
Hi, I'm Taylor Jones. My plans after school is probably going into the workforce. Mostly what I'm trying to look into is tattoo, like a tattoo artist. But I don't plan on going to college, just join the workforce. To those who are gonna be starting next year, all I say is do your best, be nice, and try to be a good listener and be on your best behavior. And also, trying to make friends. So to all the seniors that are going to be leaving the Tech Center, we wish you luck and all the finest in your futures, but also stay safe on those roads and good luck in your life.
Come on, guys. Let's work this time.
All right. Now that we cleaned up that mess, I think it's finally time to chill out.
Fine. I guess you won. Evidently, going out with a bang does more harm than good, at least for me.
But it does. Put up your feet and just relax, man. It's senior summer. We finally can. While we mellow out, here's Past Me with a game review.
Past you?
Don't overthink it.
Hello, I'm Wesley Fritz with your media review. My talker for today is the primal slash sci-fi survival game, Ark Survival Evolved. However, first, let me find a more suitable location.
Ark Survival Evolved is a survival game where creatures of both the prehistoric and futuristic varieties will try to make you just as extinct as they were.
Set on an island, or a desert, or a cave, or the desolate remains of New Mexico, Ark sees various survivors attempt to survive against brutal environments, vicious creatures, and the unrelenting rage of other gamers. From the lowly thatch hut to the environmentally friendly tech monuments, you will grow through your time in these dangerous biomes, aided by not only your friends, but the creatures you tame throughout the way. You'll fight bosses, conquer caves, and ascend as you uncover the truth about these bizarre ecosystems and their dangers. Ark Survival Evolved released in Early Access in 2015, following the wave of dinosaur games that launched after Jurassic World. It got its full release in 2018, as well as several DLC packs and a full remaster along the way, said remaster launching last year in November. It's even scheduled to get a full sequel, but given the game's reputation of delays, seeing it anytime soon is unlikely. Ark Survival Ascended, the remaster mentioned prior, is slowly regenerating the content lost between versions, and will hopefully become equal to ASE in time. While Ark has received mixed reviews throughout its lifetime, as well as a smaller community than some of its competitors, it still holds a place in many hearts, for both partially nostalgic reasons, as well as its ever-growing online presence. Ark has remained constant in the survival genre. I personally list it as one of my favorite, if not my very favorite game. Yes, it has problems, but I can overlook those for the sheer enjoyment it brings riding on the back of a T-Rex. My rating is an 11 out of 10, breaking my arbitrary scale for these reviews. This has been your media review with Wesley Fritz. Back to the show.
Huh? Yeah, I probably shouldn't overthink that.
Well, that's about all we have for our last show. This is a goodbye from both VISCOM and us seniors.
Have a great summer!
How did I get here?
I don't know!
Dude, again?
It takes the edge off. You make me feel like I'm addicted.
You're always eating Cheetos.
I can quit whenever I want.
Everyone says that. I'm actually getting concerned. Like, this is an issue.
Seriously, I can quit whenever I want. I went cold turkey last week, and I literally did not even get any shakes or cravings or itches or anything. Why don't you try and quit getting on my case about it?
You suck. I hate you. I hate those Viscops. They killed me. I'm gonna get them.
I've been mollywomped.
No!
I'm going to blow up the sun now.